بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد.
One of the accusations they have against Imam al-Hasan سلام الله عليه, propagated by Bani Umayyah, is that he used to marry many wives. In fact, some books of history, even in our books, as well, some books state that he married 70 wives. Oh, some books I was reading earlier, 300 wives. He used to marry and divorce, marry and divorce, marry and divorce, to the extent where they say Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam got on the minbar one day in Masjid al-Kufa and said, don't marry your daughters to him anymore, because he marries them and divorces them. So one man got up from Hamadan and he told him, no, we will still marry our daughters to him. He is the grandson of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. He wants to keep them, keep them. He wants to divorce them, let him divorce them. This is contradictory to the akhlaq of Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam. Since when would Amir al-Mu'mineen salamullah alayhi sits on the member and instead of talking to his own son, he tells him, son, listen, what you're doing is wrong, for example. This is not right. Why would he need to go to the member and expose him right in front of everyone else? Why would he need to do that? And interestingly, there is a Sunni scholar, not a Shia, contemporary. He has written a book called Al-Imam al-Hasan, Khamisul Khulafa al-Rashideen. Imam al-Hasan, the fifth Khalifa. Contemporary, Dr. Salabi, his name is Salabi. I have his book, anyone who's interested, it's in Arabic. He's not a Shia, he's not a follower of Ahlul Bayt. He says in his book, he says, these arguments are false. He himself is saying, false. He says, first of all, if Imam al-Hasan married so many women, where are the children? Where are the children? Imam al-Hasan alayhi salam has, according to most historians, they say 22, the most, which at the time was normal. At the time, people had many. 22 children. If he married 70 or, 300, where are the children? Where are the children? Today you have some kings, mashallah, kings, their sons, mashallah, they lose count. They don't even know who is their son anymore, your daughter. They don't know. Mashallah, they just keep on marrying and having children. So we have this. Where are the children? Two, it is contradictory to the akhlaq. Now this man is talking from the non-Shia perspective. It is contradictory to the akhlaq of the Imam al-Hasan alayhi salam, a man who was raised by his grandfather Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. It's contradictory to this akhlaq. Now from our perspective, he's an Imam al-Ma'soom. An Imam, why would he disobey his father wal-iyadu billah? Why would he do something like this? His father could have told him, for example, hypothetically speaking, if he used to do, his father could have told him, son, this is wrong. You shouldn't do this. And as an Imam al-Ma'soom, he would listen to his father. Never mind, as a mu'min, he would listen to his father. Okay. But these are propaganda created by Bani Umayyah against Imam al-Hasan alayhi salam, and they made their way into our books as well. But contemporary scholars who have studied these books, they say, these contradict the Quran, contradict the ethics of Ahlul Bayt, the akhlaq of Ahlul Bayt. And therefore, just because a hadith is in our books, we don't have any book that's called sahih, absolutely authentic. These are one of the lies they have created about Imam al-Hasan alayhi salam, the propaganda.
Ya Hussein.